apply now the reorder point model to a numerical example. In particular, the objective of the problem is to represent the expected pattern of both the inventory level and the availability, as well as to identify the average inventory level. The input data are weekly demand equal to 506 cases, order quantity equal to 462 cases, reorder point quantity equal to 530 cases, replenishment lead time equal to 4 days. Let's start from the inventory level. In order to draw its pattern, we need to identify the minimum and the maximum inventory levels. The minimum value of the inventories is equal to the safety stock level. Since the reorder point is the sum of the demand during the lead time and the safety stocks, we found the value of the safety stocks as the difference between the reorder point and the expected demand during the lead time. The expected demand during the lead time is calculated as the weekly demand, 506 cases, multiplied by the lead time in weeks, 4 days divided by 5 if you assume 5 days per week. Therefore, the value of the safety stocks, that is the minimum value of the inventory level, is calculated as 530 minus 405, and so is equal to 125 cases. The maximum value of the inventory level is found by adding to the order quantity Q, 462 cases, to the safety stocks, 125 cases, resulting in 587 cases. The graph in the picture shows the pattern of the inventory level, and we can see the minimum and maximum values we have just calculated. Now let's consider the availability. The minimum value of the availability is equal to the reorder point quantity, 530 cases. The maximum value is the sum of the reorder point and the order quantity Q, 462 cases, thus resulting in 992 cases. This is the final graph that represents the patterns of both the availability and the inventory level. In addition to the maximum and minimum values of each curve, we can observe the replenishment lead time. Now, let's calculate the average inventory level. It is the sum of the safety stocks and of the average value of the cycle stocks. The average value of the cycle stocks is half the order quantity Q, 462, so 231 cases. Therefore, the average inventory level is equal to 125 plus 231, resulting in 356 cases. With this result, we are providing an answer to both the requests of the problem. In this lecture, we have seen the features and the main parameters of the reorder point model. Please refer to the next lectures in order to understand how we can define the optimal order quantity, also called economic order quantity, and the optimal reorder point.